Take a look at this drawing. My guess is many of you will recognize one of the figures depicted. The figure I'm talking about, of course, is the one on the left, one of the most recognizable and preeminent acting talents in the history of cinema, Charlie Chaplin. But what about the man next to him? My guess is many of you won't know who this is. That's because Totò is an Italian comedian whose name recognition does not go far beyond his own national borders. So unless you live in Italy or have taken a global virtual exchange course with Italian students, the chances that you're familiar with Totò are slim. Both figures, however, share an immense passion for the art of comedy and are all but peerless in their craft. So why do most of us only know the name Chaplin? There are many reasons, but the one this video essay seeks to explore is the influence that comedic style has on a comedian's global reach. So while Chaplin was able to achieve success in foreign cinema markets such as Hollywood, Totò's influence remained strong exclusively in Italy due to his comedic style, which more overtly embedded nationalistic context than Chaplin's more universal appeal. This is Comedy in Context, Chaplin versus Totò on the international stage.
Diffidenza dei registi, invadenza degli attori, cattivo gusto, mancanza di fantasia. Ma sono soltanto questi i mali cronici che affliggono il nostro cinema comico? Chiediamolo a Totò, ritrovandolo il Valle, che con il grande attore napoletano ha colto il periodo d'oro della nostra rivista satirica.
La comicità era diventata troppo intellettualizzata, troppo occasionale, difficile. Il pubblico andava al cinema per ridere e, guarda caso, non rideva, quindi ne usciva deluso. La comicità non può essere limitata a questo o a quel periodo. La comicità è quella di sempre, antica e moderna nello stesso tempo. Prendiamo ad esempio il maestro di tutti noi, il grande Charlot.
Charlie Chaplin truly became a cultural phenomenon in 1915. Like Totò in Naples, his image was used by shops to sell merchandise. His fame spread across America and across the world, making him one of the film industry's first major international stars. Time magazine included him in their list of the 100 most important people of the 20th century for more or less inventing the global recognizability and helping turn the film industry from an industry into an art form. Whereas Chaplin has a sweet touch, eliciting the audience's sympathy for his fate, Totò's actions are more unsettling and monstrous. Through the same tools of physical comedy, the two actors are perhaps satirizing very different and very local realities. In Totò's case, his comedy is firmly situated in an Italian context, specifically a Southern Italian context. He pokes fun at the Italian bureaucracy and other Italian social norms. At times, his rhyming jokes are almost untranslatable from Italian.
E per lei, modesto attore, faccio l'ospite d'onore. Son venuto a studio uno.
This is the major reason why Totò's work never received global acclaim to the same extent as Chaplin's. While you may laugh at Totò's physical comedy, a lot of the genius of his work gets lost in translation. In the case of Chaplin, his commentary on capitalism and modernism translated well into the global stage, especially for audiences also living in capitalist economies. His humor did not require an American context to enjoy and understand. Another reason for Totò's success was his taste for nuance. He did not depend on slapstick in order to keep the audience's attention, rather he looked for nuance and subtlety in every scene which touched a chord with audiences around the world. Both Totò's and Chaplin's fandom is based on their popular image as men of the people. Their appeal rests on their proximity to the common man and that their legacy lives on beyond them. The clip in the video that shows Chaplin opening fan mail sends the message to the viewer that he cares about his audience and what they think of him. He is less removed from the common man than many of the stars of the silver screen. Chaplin was unusual in that he was able to bridge the divide between high and low culture. In fact, when he visited Germany in 1931, both the broad masses and the intellectuals expressed joy at his arrival. In 1972, Chaplin was awarded an honorary Oscar and received a standing ovation that lasted 12 minutes, making it the longest standing ovation in Oscars history. This standing ovation is a testament to Chaplin's being loved by the popular masses and also respected by those who dictate what can be established as high culture. Like Chaplin, Tito's legacy lives on, and he is still very famous in Italy, especially in Naples. Unlike Chaplin, he did not appeal as much to high culture critics. He was, however, loved by the people of Italy. In fact, his face mask is still used as an attraction in a lot of Naples pizzerias. In the Italian television clips, Tito's arrival on stage, like Chaplin, is greeted with rapturous applause, highlighting how people who did not even know him felt a sense of affection for him. In one of the clips, Tito tells Mina, an Italian singer, that he is a modest actor who is the guest of honor. Like Chaplin's fandom, Tito's fans recognize the modesty of their hero as it makes him seem less distant from everyday people. Tito made films even before the war, but he didn't gain the same success he had in theater. Producers gave him another chance with cinema after the war, but they exploited him.
Parole. Ecco perché il film comico all'estero non attacca, perché traducendo alla lettera questo film, queste battute, perde il significato originale, cioè quello del nostro idioma, e ne acquista un altro che spesso non dice niente.
Critics slated his movies and performances because they saw in these movies a return to a political disengagement which, to them, didn't fit the times they were living in. Some of these critics said that these movies could be assigned to the title of the most silly and useless films ever produced by Italian producers. This is the reason why, even after his death, Tito is still ignored by most of the academic and scholarly sources. Even the books that try to summarize his biography are not widespread, especially out of Italian borders. Both of these men treated comedy like an art form and left it forever changed. Chaplin remains beloved and iconic on a global scale due primarily to his slapstick style of physical comedy and focus on generalized themes of love and identity in films like City Lights, War and the Great Dictator, and Modernity in Modern Times. Tito remains a beloved Napolese icon for his career of satirizing issues of Italian nationalism from social inequity to the love of spaghetti. And for this, both Chaplin and Tito's legacies are sure to live on in these respective domains.